So there are a number of factors that's going to determine how long your battery system's going to work reliably. And almost always comes down to the batteries. And the two common factors that's going to determine the length of your batteries, how long they last, is one is going to be the actual discharge and recharge rate of the batteries, and two, the ambient temperature outside. So with that said, probably about you get 4 years out of a batteries, you're doing good. If you get five, you're doing excellent. But with that said, pretty much if you do every 3 to 4 years, somewhere around that, if you make it a point to go around and start testing your batteries out, that's going to be giving you a good indicator of how long, or you know, if one starts to fail out of the four, you know your other three are probably right behind it. And a way to test the batteries, if you don't already have one, is you need to get a actual battery load tester. If you don't have one of these, you need to get one. I'm going to show you how to use it.
So we're going to open up this battery backup cabinet here. That's attached to the main cabinet. And we got an Alpha battery backup system here. First thing I'm going to check here is I'm going to go into the status menu. Let's see here. Let's scroll down. There's the controls. There's the status menu, and I'm going to select that. And then I'm going to scroll until I get to the batteries. And you can see it's fluctuating around 54 and a half, you know, 54 to 55. So initially it looks like we're good, but that can be deceiving until you actually put a load on the actual batteries themselves. So today I'm gonna go ahead and take out one of these batteries, and I'm gonna show you how you're gonna use this load tester to test it. So I'm shutting this off, which is my battery breaker, and I'm gonna go ahead and unplug the set of batteries from the battery backup unit itself. So these four batteries are now disconnected from the system. And next, I'm gonna go ahead and take an individual battery out of the set of four here, disconnect it so I can do a load test on it. Disconnect this. That last unit I disconnected there was the Alpha Guard, and that's you need to take that out of the system too before I test this battery. All right, so you can see I physically disconnected this from the system. Oops, from that quick connect, disconnect. It's by itself now, so it's a lone battery. So now what we'll do is we're gonna go ahead and use the battery backup, or I'm sorry, the load tester, and put a load on it and test that. Okay, so now that I have that, I'm gonna take my positive and my negative lead off. I'm gonna put the negative lead onto the negative terminal and the positive lead onto the positive terminal. And I don't know if you can see that there. But right now, I'm showing about 13 volts just on the initial test of putting the terminals on there. Now, I'm not actually doing the test yet. There's a switch below it that you're gonna actually push, and that's going to present the load onto the battery. And that's gonna give you the true indication of how good that battery is. So let's try to focus in on that. Like I said, you got about 13 volts. I'm gonna hit this switch here. With a load on it, we're still hovering around 12 volts. So that tells me that this is a good battery. I'll test the other three out to make sure, but this is, if they all come back, that's a good system. Now, by comparison, I don't know if you can hear me or not, it's kind of windy, but I've got a set of batteries here that have not been replaced in quite some time. And I'm gonna hook this up to one of the batteries that I have disconnected, and you'll see
here that already it's not even registering the 12 volts. It's closer to the 8 volts or whatever, maybe 7 volts. And you'll see that whenever I apply the load to this, it instantly goes to zero, showing that it's a bad battery. So this is one that's going to need to be replaced.